Hi and welcome to my first video for Shadow Fireball. This is Joe Larsson and we will bring you a Bring to Light deck. I've talked about this deck before in my earlier article and why it could be interesting as a brew in this new metagame. The idea being is that it's kind of like a green-black Delirium deck. It features Ishkana, Emrakul, Gearhulk, Traverse, Ulvenwald, Vessels, Grapples, etc. A lot of its core power is there. But instead of playing Liliana, which is good in the mirror, we play Nahiri, which might be the best card versus Black Green. If you compare this card with Gideon, Gideon can be stuck up behind the Ishkana, not being able to win, while Nahiri is very hard to beat because it takes up so quickly. Also, we have some cards that Black Green usually doesn't have access to, which is basically Anguish I'm Making, for example. A very good card. Dealing with Planeswalkers, a problem that the deck usually has. Together with Bring to Light, Anguish I'm Making, and Goblin Dark Dwellers, we have a lot of ways to kill Planeswalkers. Also in the sideboard, we have the addition of blue counterspells for decks like Aetherworks Marvel, another deck that Green-Black has a very hard time dealing with. However, the deck is playing 5 colors and not 2, so that's a big difference. However, between 3 Traverse, 2 Attunes, 2 Servants, 2 Pilgrim's Eyes, Aether Hubs with others, the deck could work in this mana. So we'll see how it fares here in the league. Alright, welcome to the first match here of our standard league. We'll choose to play first with the Bring to Light, see what we have. Alright, our hand is fine, I guess. It has mana sources to removal spells, ways to stay alive. Pretty much what we want here, I believe. Alright, let's kick it off. I think we'll start off by traversing for... let's see. I think we want a white mana source here. Because then we can cast Nahiri with a red. And the only real black card we have until Gearhulk is Anguish I'm Making. Then we need white anyways. So we'll go ahead and get that. And pass the turn. See what we're playing against. Seems to be blue white. Makes the most sense out of a Prairie Stream. Where's the Heather deck? So we'll see if it runs out a copter or something that harder to deal with. Alright, seems like it's just gonna opt to pass the turn. So we will. Alright. This is pretty good draw here. It will help us hit our mana, which we obviously need here with a bunch of super expensive cards in the hand. It will also help us get the Leer for turn 5 if we want to bring to life for Ishkana, which we all know is a pretty good card versus blue-white. Alright, I think we're gonna opt to crack this in our main phase. And to play an Untap plan to kill an end of turn. Alright. An end of turn guy here, but it seems like we might have to get an Evolving Walls instead. I just want those land sources here, I think. I guess Servant is not bad either, actually. We'll go ahead and take a Servant. And we'll play a tap land. So then we can Servant and protect it with Harness Lightning if that's important. Hopefully it doesn't have spell color here to Gideon. Did I spell spells to this sprite before? Sometimes I make that mistake. Alright, let's see what we have here. Regardless, if he plays Gideon, we might be lucky enough to draw a land for our Bring Light here. And we can just Ishkana him. Alright, seems like that's not the case. However, we will opt to cast this Servant. Might be able to catch a Spell Queller with his Harness Lightning. And yeah, seems like that's gonna happen. Kill that bad boy. Whatever it is. Yes, please. We would like to cast that card. Smiley's copter. Quite the card. Luckily, we haven't seen a Gideon here so far. This card we're pretty afraid of. So Snare means mana is up for casting anything, especially if you draw land here. That would be the optimal way of getting ahead here, of course. Which can have been really good. Seems like we did not hit a land. We'll cast this Grapple. Try to get a land of that. I mean, we will for sure with Evolving Wilds. That we know. Alright. We'll get Evolving Wilds here. And we'll get a black with that. So we have all five colors. Unfortunately, we do not have... We actually don't have five sources for Bring to Light here. Since three of our lands produce red and white. Alright, we'll try to get that before attackers. Hopefully that happens and not spell queller number million getting us. Alright, Archangel Alvison. That makes sense. Maybe should have played around it. Alright, not gonna spend any energy since it's indestructible. In our turn, we can just play Goblin Dark Dwellers and kill the Savasin. It's not a bad turn. Alright, let's see what he discards. Probably a land. Yeah, seems to have a lot of lands. Yep. Alright, so next turn we can bring to light for Ishikana if we want to. It's this turn we're just gonna opt to kill this Archangel off. Grappling here would have also been pretty good, but I think we're a little bit too far behind off of the tempo here to do that. We'll get a forest with this. Could also get an island, but I think there's high chance we'll use the green mana in one turn here. Alright, so our hand is very powerful. So hopefully he won't have too much ways to stop it in times of negate or something like that. Revolution Rebuff is also something he could be playing main deck. So hopefully, maybe we can draw a land to play around that, otherwise I think we'll just have a jam. Either way, alright. I will try to jam this for sure. Bring to life, what say you? Alright, seems like it resolves. Could also get Fumigate. It's okay, but I think Ishkana is just gonna lock this up way easier. Alright, Ishkana. Nope, no response to that. Gonna sacrifice that in response, that's all fine. Get into 4 here with the dwellers. Alright. Let's see if he has a. Does he have a color? Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Unfortunately, we milled one of our Ishkana, so we can't actually get our Ishkana with this Bring to Light. However, we shouldn't be too far off Emrakul here. I think it cost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it costs 7 right now. So only needing one more mana to actually cast it. Seems like he opts to just pass a turn. Let's see what we can get with this. Okay, we can get a tracker, which I don't think we want. We can also get Fumigate, I don't think we want it either. We don't really care about this that much, it's just too slow. I think we're gonna cast Grapple first. Try to get a land for this Emrakul. Yep. And I think I'm just gonna get a Pilgrim's Eye. Since we already have another artifact creature in our graveyard. I actually mistapped there. I should have kept up another red. That was clumsy of me. That was clumsy indeed. I don't think we need to attack here. We don't really need to pressure him whatsoever. Not with Emrakul in hand. Alright, so we'll pass the turn. Most likely this should be enough to seal the deal. that. I'm just gonna cast this Emrakul. Hello, buddy. And we'll pass the turn. Alright, so killing the Emrakul, that's fine. We still get to control this turn. One choice could be, for example, Cypher's his team, but I think we can kill the thing. Alright, Selfless Spirit, we can kill that post combat. So let's see here. Copter is getting blocked by three spiders, or two spiders and I. This gets blocked by a spider. This could be blocked here, and we leave him with a spell color, I think that's fine. Let's do that. So crew that with that, since we're not gonna kill it. Attack with everything. Use the ability. Resolves, yes. Use it. Discard a planes. This blocks here. These three guys block here. And this blocks here. Okay, and then we'll rearrange so we kill Pilgrim's Eye. And this. Oh. Ah, I'm playing a little bit loosely here. I should have opted to just kill a spider. It was pretty whatever. But playing a bit loose here. But I do think we have the means to get there regardless. We shall see indeed. Alright. Pilgrim's Eye be the draw. I think. Let's see here. All the basics are out of the deck, so these are basically misses. We can get a tracker. Or we can just get an Anguish I'm making to get our Emrakul back. That's not bad either. I think we're gonna opt to do that. Let's play this. Five colors. Anguish I'm making. Targeting this one. Get our Ul Emrakul Mr. Brack. It's actually a Shia, I think, from the flavor. I don't know. Luckily, I'm not paid for doing flavor texts. Alright, so he's making a dude. Yep. I think Emrakul should be able to seal the deal here. Especially with Harness lining back up. Just gonna attack with our stuff and let that be. I'd rather keep this. Okay. Just gonna Jace on. Probably bounce my Emrakul so I can cast it again. That is completely fine. He's probably gonna attack, I presume. I think I'm actually gonna. No. I don't really need to kill it. I could just jump this turn if I actually want to. And I should be able to gobble it up with my Emrakul this turn. Nahiri, not a bad draw. Not against this Stasis Nurse. I'll give you that much. I think I'm just gonna cast Emrakul though. Pass the turn. Next turn we're probably gonna. Yeah. So we're gonna bounce. And the cleric that we build from this guy, like so, then we'll attack with these guys, and we'll block him, and this should be all she wrote. See, he got two draws here, but I don't actually nobody can be, especially with Nahiru backup and Harness Lightning. He can draw a Spellqueller when we Nahiru minus kill the CC Snare, but then we'll just Harness Lightning that anyways. Yep, still have 13 in the air. So that is totally fine. Jace's main deck, huh? It's pretty harsh. What do you have? Shooter 007. What do you have? Pretty cool game, I'll tell you that much. Made a few blunders. However, it doesn't seem like it's gonna matter too much. Alrighty then. Traverse, that could be a tracker or whatever. Not much left to get with it, actually. Alright. Yeah, we're just gonna attack him. The spider can attack Jace, so he can't bounce next turn. These can attack him in case he has like a Spellqueller to block this. I don't wanna have to use my Harness Lightning. Yeah, we'll see that. Might be an Avacyn. Yeah. That's why he minused. But we're just gonna opt to shoot it down before it hits play. Alright, and we win the first game. We'll see how we're gonna cyber here. I think one transgress on the draw, Gideon can prove to be a problem. We do like Limvala here, I think. Cards that are less good. Radiant Flames is pretty mediocre, especially against Spellcallers. Horrendous. The spell is not that bad, however, I feel like on the draw we don't really need to force things through. I think Spellcaller is also going to be a fairly good card. Especially on the draw to get a Gideon off of our backs. And Sigarda is fairly interesting too, I would say. So let's see what we're going to remove for these. Alright, I think we can take out one Pilgrim's Eye on the draw. And I want Bring to Light. So we're just gonna let's see here. This is tough. I haven't figured out the exact way how to cyber yet against this deck. They run different configurations depending on which counter is supposed to run and how aggressive they are supposed to push. Some go pretty long, some go pretty fast. I think we can remove. The servant or a tune. Let's see. Right, no. Let's not put this cigar in. It really depends whether this deck is slow or not, but let's do this first. Okay, welcome back to the second game versus Blue White post board. Won the first game, and let's see if we keep it down. I think this hand's fine, it's not great. I think we should probably play the Golden White first, get a white, and then we'll see whether we get a blue or something else, depending on what we draw. It's not great, but every two, three land hand is it's not great. Alright. Alright, so I think we're definitely going to lean towards that Queller. Get an island here. Oh, sorry. Plains. Because that we will need for sure for any of these three spells. Alright, so we do have red. It's a little bit awkward that this will come into play tapped. If we choose to get a blue this turn. However, I do think it will still be worth it. So we'll do that. Get a blue and pass the turn. So next time we can choose whether to cast this or not. Anyways, right, seems like blue was the right call. So high chance there's gonna be a spell card to come down here now. We could take that if we want. If it does have Gideon, however, this is gonna be awesome. Doesn't seem like he's gonna play anything, which is even better. Seems like he kept a fairly slow hand against us. Got a lot of counter spells possibly. We have no problem playing that game, especially with a spell quality now, also a grapple that we can play at the end of his next turn. So hopefully we can catch him with his pants down here. His or hers. Alright, so nothing. Which is fine. We'll cast a grapple. Seems like there's a chance for a Avis in here. Alright, I think we're gonna take this Blooming Marsh because it's as tapped as Evolving Wilds are, but it's also green and black. And we kinda want that black mana right now. Alright. Play that. And since it might have a Avis in here, I think we're gonna cast this Nahiri. Just to get something on the board. Possibly, we can also try to get Delirium with it, discarding the other Nahiri. I think that's fine. If we use a counter spell for this, this is fine too. Let me see one player. Okay, yeah, that's okay. Since we have instant speed removal spells, we are definitely okay with this happening. So what is this? Reflect damage. Untapped land here would be great. I'll tell you that much. Right, it is not an untapped land. I think we might opt to cast this Spring to Light while we can. Netting ourselves. We don't have Delirium, unfortunately. But we do have Goblin Dark Swallers. So that at least blocks something. Kinda wish I brought that Linval in now. Or kept that Fumigate. However, we'll play it. This plays around spell color. It does not play around another counter spell, but I think that's okay. Right, we'll probably wait until we get what we get. Okay, get our dwellers. Guess this. Right. So there's a chance he has another equaler here. At least we get this body on the table. So cast this. Seems like it resolves. Not bad. Alright, plus it. I think we're gonna plus discarding this Nahiri to get Delirium. I don't think we need one either. No, for sure we don't need one. Maybe do another one. And I think he might have just Stasis Snare here. I think it's gonna be really hard for him to play against my deck with this many instant spells and also powerful spells such as Bring to Light. It's hard to have a mana for everything if it doesn't have actual Void Shatter. Alright, so Nahir is on the battlefield. What's also somewhat awkward against this deck sometimes is that the creatures aren't always great to balance with Jace and stuff like that, so. Or reflect image. Speaking of bounce balls. Alright. Alright, so this costs 4 mana right now. We could get Dwellers into Grapple. We kind of want to have our Nahiri sticking around here. We kind of want to save this anguish I'm making. I think I'm gonna plus here. Discarding this Vantage. Alright, it's not a bad draw. I think We're gonna start by casting this. No, actually. Maybe we have to guess the language I'm making here. So I don't know the situation, whether we want to cast our anguish on making it or keep mana up, etc. But I think casting this is a little bit better. Now here taking 2 is not the biggest deal in the world. Alright, so we do get to queller that. Queller's queller. So, scary game. Quelling quellers, because out of nowhere you can get a counter spell, but I think it's worth it here. It somehow protects Nahiri. Also, if he bounces that or kills that, that's also fine. Yep, sure. Getting clues with this kind of deck is not bad, I'll tell you that much. Alright, so we have 4 Delirium still. Bring to Light would be an excellent draw. That is also an excellent draw. I think we're gonna start by trying to play that. See if it works. Problem is that we can't play Goblet Darkwaters in that case. Let's see here. Tricky situation. Okay. And have another queller. I think that's okay. It's not great. Alright. Let's start by sacrificing this. See this mana. We can also always Aether Hub if draw a Bring to Light here. Alright, so we drew a land. Doesn't change much. Let's try to lighten this up. See if we wanna go up or down with Nahiri. Alright, so that seems to be working. We'll tick this up. Discarding this servant, and I shall pass the turn. Alright, so we're getting awfully close here to Emrakul. We're missing artifact and enchantment, which means we have 5 types, meaning it costs 8. So we have options to play it here. The scary part is there's a high chance he has Summer Dismissal, which is something we really don't want to get hit by. Alright, so let's play Dismissal. Let's see what's in it. A Pilgrim's Eye. Guess that's a real good pick here. Other than Servant, I think we might actually just discard that. Try to get another draw. Then we have all the time, so Emrakul is barely gonna cast anything. Alright, let's cast this Dwellers. Try to cast a Traverse, I think. Hopefully this won't get stubborn and dial. Alright, Revolution 3 buff. That's fine, let me see, we'll probably not play something else this turn or make a token. As long as we have this Nahiri, we're gonna slowly get ahead, I think. Alright, Gideon shortens the clock, however, that leaves us up to cast Emrakul. Even through Revolution Rebuff, so... I think we'll be outmost fine here. Alright, Brings Light, also not a good card. However, I think we're gonna try to play through Negate here by playing this Emrakul this turn. We're gonna minus and kill this, so we get both of his creatures. Kill that. Cast Emrakul. Doesn't really matter what we keep up here. Right, pass the turn. Okay, so we did have Spell Shrivel. A lot of removals for Emrakul, that's for sure. Okay, Reflect Image. That's interesting. Alright, this turn is not going to be the easiest one. We cannot cast a Descend and Spell Shrivel it. We can cast Declaration and Spell Shrivel it, which is okay, I think. Can also get Reflect the Mage, but Reflect the Mage doesn't do much against our deck really. So I think Reflect the Mage is okay. I guess that leaves him out of options. Biggest problem is Descend. He will most likely descend next turn regardless of what happens. Could also animate Gideon and bounce Gideon. Nah, I already used. Make an emblem, I think. So let's make an emblem. Let's cast this Deckstone. See if they fix this so far. Doesn't seem like I can do anything about this. Okay, there we go. Before I was used to not being able to cast that. Right, no. Let's attack me. Lock. I'm gonna get descended next turn, but then we'll bring the light, so we should be fine. And we're gonna start taking up Nahiri. Okay, so he does reflect damage it. That's very greedy. Right, so now we actually get his descend. Yep. No. Cast his Brings Light. I think we get Ishkana. Cast it. Past the turn. We're playing a little bit here against the clock as well. Recording and talking does that to you. Some are cool. Cast Tracker. Pass the turn. Take with that into Emrakul. Gobble, 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 Pac-Man that up. And hopefully we should have him dead here. Let's cast this first. Get a clue. Select that clue. Right. Just attack. This is still lethal if it doesn't have anything. Okay. Seems like he has some kind of stasis there, alright. I'm just gonna use this ability. Try to end the game a little bit faster. And I don't think we use this yet, but we'll use that on stasis now. Damn one. Damn recall back. Pause the turn. And that should be everything. Alright, so let's join us for match number 2. We'll be right back.